everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Fran. I create content on self-love, personal growth, conscious living, and everything I've learned on my own healing journey. So I started with occasional binge eating in my teenage years, which later developed into bulimia for about 15 years. And this is a topic I've been personally committed to through self-education and professional guidance. In my last video, I talked about the most common reason why people binge eat, which is diet-induced binge eating type. So if you have skipped that video, I have put the link down in the description box and you can check it out later. Also a short claimer, this video is not about diagnosis for bulimia and anorexia because intensity, frequency, and triggers vary greatly. If you're in a situation that you feel out of control with binge eating, I strongly advise you to go and talk to a professional. So to continue with today's topic, let's discuss other common reasons why people binge eat or emotional eat. Besides from diet-induced type, food can be also used as a source of self-soothing and distraction with various types of emotional triggers. There are a lot of studies that have shown the strong connection between body's oral part with emotional expression. According to Sigmund Freud, psychological development in childhood takes place during five psychosexual stages: oral, anal, phallic, latency, and genital. Each stage represents the fixation of libido, which can be roughly translated as sexual drives or instincts on a different area of the body. So the oral stage refers to roughly the age between 0 to 1 year old. This is age that we cannot survive without the caretaker. During this age, the only connection we have towards the external world is our mouth. Just try to recall like how infants usually try to put everything in their mouth and bite them, including their own fingers and toes, right? And this is the only way that we know that there's external world exists besides us. In addition, the only way babies have to express their emotions and needs are through oral parts. For example, they laugh like really loud when they're entertained, and they cry or make loud noises when their needs are unmet to get caretaker's attention to look after them because they cannot do that by themselves, right? As we grew up, we're not able to deal with the negative emotions directly because most of the time we're not conscious what it is and how we're feeling. From our biological instincts, we would try to use something oral like drinks or food to cope with that emotions indirectly. For example, when we are feeling this overwhelming sense of emptiness, we would try to fill our stomach, and we would try to feel full through food, so we feel complete. We often view binge eating as a problem, yet binge eating is actually a symptom of deeper issues within us. I wanted to share some typical emotional triggers that are extremely common and some cases I've studied about and personally relate to. So the first common emotional trigger is loneliness. This is a case that's very typical. I think it's going to be very helpful for you to understand. A man starts binge eating ever since he starts to work. And every day when he gets out of work, he would take the bus alone to those different night markets in town, and he would try like different kind of food stands until he's extremely full to a point that he couldn't take anymore. So he would go home and every night, and he repeats for about a year. His confusion was that he wasn't even hungry at night, yet he couldn't resist the urge. Under his therapist's guidance, he started to recall like everything before the onset of the event, of the actual event, of his whole binging thing. So he claims that he felt kind of lonely when he goes back home, like to his little room. And he feels he lacks connection. Being on the bus makes him feel somehow connected to the crowd, and even more so when he actually arrives at the night markets and joins the revelers to try different kind of food and feel the excitement. Under this particular feeling and emotional state, food becomes his source of coping with this emotional void, with this emptiness feeling, right? Under a therapist's guidance and advisement, he actually joined a couple of clubs. Being with people who are similar to him, who share his common interests, make him feel understood and seen and connected. So as they bonded, this urge to binge eat alone at night gradually faded. I personally can relate to this case so much because I've noticed that on Friday night or on weekends, when I don't go out with friends, when I don't have plans to do, I would literally feel sad for myself because I feel like weekends and Friday night are for having fun or for a celebration with people. And when I don't do that, I literally just feel bad. I feel sad. And also I feel isolated somehow. After I've discovered this pattern for binge eating, I always try to plan ahead for Friday night or weekends. Even if my friends are occupied, even if they don't have time for me, I would treat myself something fancy to eat. And also choose a great movie for me to watch so that I feel satisfied while taking care of myself instead of being left alone. When I find alternative things to do that make me happy and connected, I wouldn't use food as a source of happiness anymore. The second common trigger is anxiety. This could happen under the particular situation that you feel stressful or just the general overwhelming feeling that you feel things are out of control, you feel helpless and vulnerable. And food can be the best procrastination and distraction for you to use to avoid dealing with those intense feelings directly, even though consequently you can be left with and replaced by even stronger feeling of guilt and shame after binge eating. To be specific, when we feel stressful facing a challenge, when we feel like things are hard to begin with and hard to tackle, even deal with perfectly, we would procrastinate. Because as human beings, our primal needs are to be seen as capable and to be even perfect, right? And when we feel like we are going to fail to gain the approval and validation that we want, that we yearn for, and thoughts about food were kicking as a way of procrastination. Those are excuses and those are the exact phrases I used to come up with all the time. Oh, I suddenly have the appetite for chocolate. I better hurry up and finish those stuff because I might be hungry later. The chips I had are just too salty and I need something sweet to drink with, like boba. Normally at the first sip or the first bite of the yummy food, we couldn't stop. Like, before you know it, we would have finished everything on hand and we probably have ordered more than we had appetite for and crashed 4,000 calories already. The third common trigger is self-loathing. I myself check this box every single time. Given the trauma that I've gone through as a child, I never got enough positive feedback from home, so I always had this kind of low self-esteem, which made me prone to self-loathing-induced binge eating. So how should I describe this feeling of self-loathing? Just try to picture it as, like, precisely as death energy, because I hated myself so much that I wanted to destroy myself. So I feel like I was completely ripped of the right to exist in the world. And for people who have ever felt this way, I wanted to give you a hug because this is extremely difficult to deal with, and I feel you. This feeling can be so strong that we don't know how to deal with, so the only way we have to turn to is food, because there's nobody behind us. At least that's how we feel, right? Food is basically used as a way to punish ourselves because we wanted to stuff ourselves with all the bad shit, with all the sinful, with all the bad food. We try to stuff ourselves to the last minute before our stomach explodes. And that literally feels like death energy. As opposed to self-loathing, what would people who love themselves would do? They would tell themselves, like, having a cup of extra bites is enough because there might be yummy food tomorrow. Having a bad mood today is okay because tomorrow it might be a better day and there are better things tomorrow and every day down the road. They feel like life is hopeful, so they don't want to hurt themselves right now. They treasure every moment of their life. They wanted to take care of themselves. For self-loathers, it literally feels like they wanted to give up right now. They wanted to explode this moment out of self-hatred and self-destruction. They don't want to anticipate another minute of living because time and space seem extremely limited to self-loathers. In addition, another factor might be playing at the same time, which is self-soothing, right? Because this feeling of self-loathing so strong and so tense, they wanted to use food to soothe this tension and to distract themselves from current moment. And especially if we're on a diet, especially we are chronic dieters, that when we let go of our dietary goal, when we let go of the restriction of food, we would feel literally very free and joyful and light and experience a short period of pleasant sensation. The fourth common trigger is feeling fat. I list this under this category because it's not the actual fact that we are fat or we have put on weight. It's just a false and exaggerated belief that trigger real emotions, which is a cognitive distortion. I first heard about this concept from the famous British psychiatrist Christopher Fairburn, who devoted years into researches on binge eating. According to him, it's one of the most triggering cues of binge eating for people who overconcern their body image. It blew my mind because it's speaking my personal truth for more than a dozen years. Whenever I ate a little bit extra out of my diet or plan, I feel fat. I literally feel like I've put on a couple of pounds already, my face got bigger, and my stomach bulges, and my thigh bloated. I would start the cycle feeling fat, self-loathing, binge eating. The fear of eating anything at all would be blown out of proportion. Those are the four common binge eating triggers that reflect our use of food as a source of self-soothing and distraction. So now, I wanted to look back in your life. Has there been a specific occasion or scenario that you're most likely to binge under? If you haven't discovered a very clear pattern, the best way to discover it is by keeping a food journal. So jot down everything you eat in a day and your mood at that time, including feelings, emotions, and incidents that trigger your urges to binge. I guarantee you will find a very clear pattern after a couple of weeks. After the pattern becomes visible, I wanted to identify the most common trigger for you, because bringing everything to your consciousness would help you tackle them one by one. And this is how I healed from 15 years of bulimia. All right, my friends, thanks for sitting through this video. I hope it's helpful. Please let me know if you're interested in knowing how to write a food journal and how to use that to tackle your binge eating. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you.